Hello everyone. So today we are going to discuss some important topics from the geography related to earth locational aspects. So the topics we are going to discuss are mentioned on your screen. Please pause the video and go through it. Let's begin. The first we are going to discuss is the movement of the earth or the motion of the earth. So it is of a two type. One is around the sun and another one is on its own axis. So the movement of the earth around the sun is called revolution. As you can see, the earth is revolving around the sun. So earth is revolving around the sun on a particular path, and that path on which earth is revolving around the sun, this path is called earth's orbit. So now let's talk about the earth's orbit. So the earth orbit is not a perfect circle. It is elliptical or slightly oval shaped. So now you have to imagine if it is a perfect circle. So let's imagine if this is the sun and this is the earth's orbit, which is perfect circle. So what happened? The distance from the sun to the earth is always remain equal. Okay, but now as we can know, this is the elliptical shape, like this shape. So what happened? There is one point in the orbit when earth is closest to the sun, and there is another point when the earth is farthest from the sun. So when earth in its orbit is closest to the sun, this is called perihelion, and when earth is farthest from the sun, that is called aphelion. So I hope now you understand what is perihelion and what is aphelion. So let's revise. The earth is revolving around the sun, that is called revolution, and it is revolving on a particular path, and that path is called earth's orbit, and the earth's orbit is of an elliptical shape. So what happened? There is a point in the orbit when earth is closest to the sun, that is called perihelion, and when earth in its orbit is farthest from the sun, that is called aphelion. So now the earth takes approximately 365 days to complete one revolution, and that these approximately 365 days called the earth year or a 1 year. And because of this revolution, seasons are formed that we will discuss later. And another movement of the earth is called on its own axis, that is called rotation or spinning. So the movement of the earth on its own axis like this is called rotation. To complete one rotation, earth took 24 hours, and that is called earth day. Because of this rotation on its own axis, day and nights are formed, and earth is rotating from east to west anti-clockwise. As you can see here, earth is rotating from west to east in an anti-clockwise. But earth is not like this. Its axis are like this. You can see here its axis. This is like axis, earth's axis, and this is the equator. We can say earth is inclined. But if you see, this is the earth's orbital plane. This is day. If we have to imagine here the earth's orbit, it is like this. This is earth's orbit and this is axis. If we see, the perpendicular line from the earth's orbit is like this. If it is not inclined, then the earth would be like this. Okay, this is a perpendicular line from the orbital plane, and this is new, but earth is inclined like this. So inclination of the earth is called earth's tilt, or the earth tilt is also called obliquity. Okay, the tilt of the earth is also called obliquity. So we can see that inclination of earth tilt is 66.5 degrees with earth orbit. This is earth orbit, and this is the axis of the earth with the angle of the axis of the earth with the orbital plane is of 66.5 degrees, but the angle of the earth axis with the perpendicular line from the earth's orbit is of 23.5 degrees, and this 23.5 degrees is called inclination or the obliquity, or the axis tilt. So the 23.5 degrees, we can say the earth is tilted 23.5 degrees with the vertical line from the Earth orbital plane to the axis. Okay, so I hope now you understand what is tilt, what is obliquity, and how day and nights are formed, etc. So now let's come to the latitude and longitudes. These are the latitude and longitudes are the fundamental concept to learn the location of the Earth, location of a particular place on the globe or on the Earth. Okay, so now let's understand from here. So let's start from the parallels or the latitude. What is latitude? Latitude is the angular distance measured north or south from the equator. Okay, this is the angular distance measured from north or from north from angular distance measured north or south from the of the equator. So if you have to imagine now, this is a 3D figure. This is the circumference of the Earth. So this is the center of the Earth. So and you have to imagine if this is the 30 degree parallel. So you have to have all the places on this 30 degree parallel. The angular distance from this center of the Earth to this place is 30 degree. Towards the 30 degree, 30 degree. If it is like 60 degree here, so the angular distance from this place to all these places of on this longitude or this parallel is of 60 degree. For example, here you can see these are the parallel, these are the imaginary lines, these lines connecting all points on the same latitude. For example, this is the 30 degree parallel or 30 degree latitude. So all the places on this longitude, on this parallel, all the places are of 30 degree. All these imaginary lines are parallel to equator and or latitudes. These parallels are the circular lines. Okay, these are the circular lines east-west direction of measured between 0 degree to 90 degree north or 0 degree to 90 degree, 0 degree to 90 degree north or 0 degree to 90 degree south. So distance between two parallel is always remain equal. As you can see, if this is a parallel and this is another parallel, the distance between these two parallels will always remain equal. That is why these are called parallels. And these parallels are reduced in length and increase in value till they converge at a point near pole. Okay, so as you can see, these parallels are reducing in length. The length of this parallel is more than length of this parallel. Length of this parallel is more than the length of this parallel. So the length of these parallels are reducing as they go towards the pole, but their value of angle is increasing as they go towards the poles. As you can see, this is a 30 degree south, this is a 60 degree south. So the angular value is increasing as they go from the equator towards poles, and their length is reducing. You can see this is the Earth. This is the equator. Equator is the largest of the all circles. All this equator is the largest parallel, or we can say this is a great circle. Its circumference is 360 degree, and equator divides the Earth into two equal hemisphere. This is northern hemisphere and this is southern hemisphere. And same goes to the meridians. These are again the the imaginary lines we have drawn. Imaginary lines. What is meridian? Meridians means the midday noon or the sun's highest position in the sky. So these meridians are of a semicircle. These are the perfect circles, but these are the semicircles, and they are cutting across the equator at the right angle. All the meridians cutting equator at the 90 degree angle. Okay, so all these meridians are of equal length. As we have seen in case of parallels, they are not equal length. Their length is reducing as they go towards the poles. But in case of meridians, all the meridians are equal. Okay, so and these are 0 degree to 180 degree west and 0 degree to 180 degree east, and 180 degree is a common meridian. Okay, so now let's come to the prime meridian. There is also a prime meridian that is passing through the Greenwich Observatory in London. This is the place where they decided to locate a place with the help of these parallels and meridians. So 0 degree is also called Greenwich meridian, and that 0 degree meridian divides the earth into two equal hemispheres, that is the eastern hemisphere and the western hemisphere. And with the help of these two, latitude and longitude, we can locate a place on earth. For example, if we can see, this is the place in America, but we have to locate it properly. So we can see this is the 30 degree north, and imagine if this is a 0 degree prime meridian, then we can say this is the 30 degree in north and 30 degree in west hemisphere. So this is how we locate a particular place on the globe. Okay, so these are the, and there we can see there are a grids, there are a number of grids formed due to this. On these are the network of lines crossing each other horizontally and vertically, and means horizontally means parallels, and vertically means meridians. So these cutting each other and intersect at the right angle. Okay, with the help of these, we locate a place on the globe. Here we can see the main equators of the earth. This is the equator, or the main latitude, important latitudes on the earth. This is the equator, or which divides the earth into two equal hemisphere, that is the northern hemisphere and the southern hemisphere. This is 0 degree north or 0 degree south, we can say 0 degree latitude. And to the 23 and a half degree north, we can find this is the Tropic of Cancer. And to south, 23 and a half degree south is the Tropic of Cancer. And the sun is overhead always between these two tropics. Okay, so we say this is, these are the tropics. And 63 and half degree south is a Antarctic Circle, and 63 and a half degree north, there is a Arctic Circle. I hope now you understand. And this is the prime meridian dividing the earth into two equal hemispheres, that is the eastern hemisphere and the western hemisphere. Here you can see whatever we have discussed, you can read it here. And this is the the heat zones, we can say. So here this, we can see this is the tilt of the earth. This is not, the earth is not like this, this is the tilt of the earth. And this is the equator. And this line which shows that here is the sun, and this line which shows that this side, on this side this is the night and this side this is the day. This line, this circle is called circle of illumination. Okay, so the sun rays fall vertically always on between the tropics. So between the tropics, we can say this is the torrid zone or the tropical zone. And between the Tropic of Cancer and the Arctic Circle, or we can say the Tropic of Capricorn and the Antarctic Circle, between these we can say this is the temperate zone, or we can say this is the North Temperate Zone and this is the South Temperate Zone. And near the poles, towards, from the Arctic Circle to the South Pole, or from the Antarctic Circle to South Pole, or the Arctic Circle to the North Pole, this region is called frigid zone. Here the sun rays always fall slanting. Okay, so now I hope you understand the heat zone. This is the torrid zone or the tropical zone. This is the North Temperate Zone. This is the South Temperate Zone. And towards the pole, there is the frigid zone, the North Frigid Zone and the South Frigid Zone. Now let's come to the equinoxes and solstices. So what is solstices? Here you can see this is solstices, this solstice, and these two are called equinoxes. So solstice is that time of the year when the sun's vertical rays falls over one of the two tropics. Okay, so now here if we can see, okay, if we see this situation of the June 21, okay, so there is, this is the North Pole and this is the Tropic of Cancer, and this is the equator, and towards this is the Tropic of Capricorn, and this is the South Pole. the okay. So here in this situation, the sun's vertical rays always fall on the directly fall on the Tropic of Cancer and the Northern Hemisphere. Okay, sun rays directly on the Tropic of Cancer are here, and that means that more heat in the Northern Hemisphere. Okay, because Northern Hemisphere is tilted towards the sun here. Okay, and area near to poles are always having less heat, but in this case, the North Pole is having a 24 hours daylight, as if it is slanting, but it is getting 24 hours daylight, and the South Hemisphere, that is the South Freeze Zone, or we can say South Pole, is not getting sun rays at all. Okay, and there is a summer in the Northern Hemisphere and the winter in the Southern Hemisphere. Area beyond the Arctic Circle are getting the daylight for all 24 hours, and there is a long day. At this situation, this is the longest day in the Northern Hemisphere and shortest night in the Northern Hemisphere, but reverse in the Southern Hemisphere. For the Southern Hemisphere, this is the longest night. Okay, so I hope now you understand what is happened in the summer solstice. So now, if we talk about the autumn equinox, okay, what happened in the autumn equinox on the September the 23rd, the sun's sun rays falls directly on the equator here. Okay, for example, this is equator, this is Northern Hemisphere, this is North Pole, this is South Pole, and this is Tropic of Capricorn, this is Tropic of Cancer. So sun's direct rays falls on the here equator, and days and nights are equal here, and there is the autumn in the Northern Hemisphere and spring in the Southern Hemisphere. Now let's come to the winter solstice. This is winter solstice, 22nd of December. Here what happened is the Southern Hemisphere is tilted towards the sun, as you can say. This is the equator, this is the Tropic of Capricorn, which get direct vertical sun rays is getting on the Tropic of Capricorn, and the Northern Hemisphere is tilted far away from the sun, while the Southern Hemisphere is tilted towards the sun, and sun rays are directly on the Tropic of Capricorn. There is more heat in the Southern Hemisphere and the less heat in the Northern Hemisphere. So what happened in this there is a summer in the Southern Hemisphere. So there is a longest day in the Southern Hemisphere and the shorter night. But in the Northern Hemisphere, there is the longer nights and the shorter days. And what these are reverse, I mean, always reverse in these Northern and the Southern Hemisphere. What happened in the spring equinox here, which is 21st of March, the sun's vertical rays falls on the equator again, and there is equal day and equal night, spring in the Northern Hemisphere and autumn in the Southern Hemisphere. So I hope now you understand how the seasons are changing with the duration of the revolution of the earth. For example, this is the Tropic of Cancer, this is the equator, and this is the Tropic of Capricorn. So now let's discuss this with the 2D map, not with the circles. So this is Tropic of Cancer, this is equator, and this is Tropic of Capricorn. On 21st June, what happened? The sun's direct rays fall on the Tropic of Cancer here. This is the 21st of June. What happened? Now Earth is going toward this. Earth is revolving like this. So what happened? The Earth and sun's rays are starting shifting towards the equator, because on this September 23rd, what happened? The sun's direct rays falls on the equator. So the sun's sun overhead, it started shifting towards the equator. And on the September 23rd, what happened? Sun is overhead at the equator. And now Earth is revolving towards this side. So at here, what happened? The Earth, sun's vertical rays, sun's direct rays falls on the Tropic of Capricorn. So on the Earth, sun is overhead on the Tropic of Capricorn on December December 22nd. Okay. So what happened? So our sun is overhead, is going towards the Tropic of Capricorn, and again it is, the sun is overhead, never beyond the tropics you can never find sun is overhead. So what happened now? Sun is moving again towards the equator, towards the, in the March situation, that is March 21st. So sun is overhead, moving again towards the on the March 21st, sun is again overhead at the equator, and again then June 21st now again to there. Okay, so what happened? The sun is overhead two times at the equator, and sun is never overhead beyond the tropics. So I hope now you understand the revolution of the earth and the sun's direct rays on over, or the sun is overhead situation. Now, because of this, there are four seasons formed, that is winter, summer, monsoon or post-monsoon. This is the constellation, or the, when these days there are a lot of technology has been developed, but our ancestors use these kind of constellation, see these, and you know, to find the direction they use. I hope you understand this video. If you have any doubt, please comment below. Thank you for watching this video.